Hello, my friends. Oh my goodness, I miss all of my Sunday school friends so much. I hope you remember me. I'm your teacher, Miss Laura. And even though we haven't been able to meet in person for a while, I've been thinking about you guys a lot. And I hope you're all doing really well staying at home with your moms and dads and families. And I'm very happy that I'm able to do your Sunday school lesson with you this week. So we have three stories that I'm going to read to you. And while I read you those stories, I want you guys to think about what they really mean. And right now, what I want you to do is go ahead and talk to your moms or your dads or your babysitters and bring together a few things that we can have while we're reading the stories, okay? So the things that you're gonna need for today, super simple. We're going to need a piece of paper and some crayons so that all of you can color while I'm reading you the story, whatever you're inspired by, whatever you feel when you're reading this story. And then when we're finished reading the story, we're gonna make a little altar and we're gonna put our stories on that altar. So get papers and crayons to draw your picture while I read the story. And if you have a little table at home, we're gonna put a nice piece of cloth on the table, like a little tablecloth. Or even you could put a nice napkin on there to use as a little tablecloth. And a candle if your mom and dads are around and if that's okay with them. And then I'm gonna put on the table as a little offering, I have pictures of my little daughters, Louisa and Rebecca, and I'm going to put the pictures that they draw, that they are inspired by the story to draw, as well as some photographs of them because I love them so much. And that's always my offering and my thanks and my prayers. So go get together the things that you need, crayons, paper, a little cloth to put on a table, maybe some flowers to put on the table if you have any. And we're gonna put your offerings on the table when we're done, your pictures, okay? Go put your things together and I'll get ready to read you the story in the next video. Hi friends, it's Miss Laura again. All right, did everybody gather what they needed? I hope so. All right, I'm gonna read you three stories, and as I'm reading the stories, I want you to color a picture, something that you're thinking about, what these stories make you think about as I'm reading them. So the first story is the story of the rich man and Lazarus. There was a rich man who dressed in purple and fine linen and lived in luxury every day. At his gate was laid a beggar named Lazarus. Poor Lazarus was covered in boo-boos and longing to eat what fell from the rich man's table. He was a hungry fellow, poor Lazarus. Even the dogs came. Oh, poor fella. The time came when the beggar died and the angels carried him to Abraham's side. The rich man also died and he was buried. He looked up one day after he was buried and saw Abraham far away with Lazarus by his side. So he called to him, "Father Abraham, have pity on me and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue because I'm in agony." Poor rich man, he was suffering. But Abraham replied, "Son, remember that in your lifetime you received good things, while Lazarus received bad things. But now he's comforted here, and you are in agony. And besides all this, between us and you, a great chasm has been set in place, so that those who want to go from here to you cannot, nor can anyone cross over from there to us." The rich man answered, "Then I beg you, Father, send Lazarus to my family, for I have five brothers. Let him warn them so they will also not come to this place of torment." Abraham replied, "They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them." "No, Father Abraham," the rich man replied, "but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent." He said to them, Abraham said to them, "If they don't listen to Moses and the prophets, they won't be convinced even if someone rises from the dead. What does that make us think about? What do you think that rich man should have done while he was alive and poor Lazarus was suffering right outside his gate? Did the rich man make good choices, do you think? I think maybe he didn't make very good choices when it came to helping out poor Lazarus. That didn't work out for him too well in the end. So the next story I have for you is the parable of the Pharisee and the tax collector. To some who were confident of their own righteousness and looked down on everyone else, Jesus told this parable. Two men went up to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood by himself and prayed, God, I thank you that I am not like other people, robbers, evildoers, bad folks, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give a tenth of all I get. But the tax collector stood at a distance. He would not even look up to heaven, but beat his chest and said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. I tell you that this man, rather than the other, went home justified before God. For all those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. Do you guys know what it means to humble yourself? All right, friends. So now it's time for your third story that we're going to read about choices that people make. This one's called The Widow's Offering. As Jesus looked up, he saw the rich putting their gifts into the temple treasury. He also saw a poor widow put in two very small copper coins. Truly I tell you, he said, this poor widow has put in more than all the others. All these people gave their gifts out of their wealth, but she, out of her poverty, put in all she had to live on. So if you think about it, all of these stories were about the kinds of choices that we make to giving and taking care of others in our community, and what kind of good choices we could make and how we can help others. So that's something I want you all to be thinking about. I just love it when you all help others. So now we're gonna do a fourth video where I'm gonna show you the altar that we put together, or I'm gonna send you a picture, and then we'll have our closing prayers, okay? So I hope your pictures have all turned out beautifully, and I hope you can put them all on your own little altars. And maybe you can have your moms and dads take pictures of your altars or the pictures that you drew and send them to me, because I would love to see what kind of artwork was inspired by these amazing stories. Did everybody finish doing their drawings? I bet they're amazing, and I really hope you have your mom and dad send them to me so I can take a look. So I'm gonna show you the little altar that I made. Notice that all the stories today are about offering and giving to others. So I put together a little altar with my offerings, and I'm gonna show it to you now and kind of explain it. All right, so here is my altar table. I've got my holy book, I've got a candle here, and I'm gonna put these two pictures of my children on there, because my children just mean the world to me and they are a gift from heaven. So I'm gonna put these right here in my holy book to put on my little altar as an offering. I hope you all enjoyed the stories that we read today, and I hope you had a great time drawing the pictures, and I really, really look forward to seeing you all back in our Sunday school classroom just as soon as we can get together again. All my love, be well, and praying for all of you. Bye.